Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to my presentation about the inline quality monitoring of distal exhaust fluid by using the 3 omega method. Unfortunately, if you see this video now, we have some technical issues and you see the pre-recorded video. Nevertheless, I hope you enjoy the video. And so let's start. I structured my talk as following. First, I will motivate the need of a quality sensor of diesel exhaust fluid in the diesel combustion process and the possibility that it could be measured with a thermal method. The thermal principle in this investigation is the 3 omega method. Second, I will talk about the sensor, the measurement setup, and the measurement procedure. Finally, I will discuss the results, and in the end, I will conclude the talk and give a short outlook. Probably most of you are familiar with a diesel engine and the diesel combustion process. The diesel combustion process produces harmful nitrogen oxides. However, these nitrogen oxides can be converted by the use or can be converted to pure nitrogen and water by the use of the diesel exhaust fluid, often known as AdBlue. The diesel exhaust fluid contains 1/3 of urea and 2/3 of water. The conversion takes place by several steps. First, the diesel exhaust fluid is injected and mixed up with the nitrogen oxide. A thermolysis and a hydrolysis convert the urea into ammonia. And this ammonia reacts with the nitrogen oxide to nitrogen and water by the so-called selective catalytic reduction. However, the correct urea concentration in water of the diesel exhaust fluid is crucial for this reduction, and the wrong concentration can break this selective catalytic reduction, and no conversion of the harmful nitrogen oxides take place. Therefore, it is also crucial to monitor the quality of the diesel exhaust fluid. And in this talk, we will present a possibility to do this quality monitoring of the diesel exhaust fluid by the 3 omega method. An advantage or advantages of using a thermal method are that the sensors are often long-term stable, small, and cost efficient. In this talk, we will think about that the quality sensor is located in the diesel exhaust fluid tank. So first, I will introduce the 3 omega method. The 3 omega method is a well-known method to measure thermal conductivity and heat capacity. However, one also can use the 3 omega method to distinguish between different fluids because the thermal properties are often different for different fluids. The 3 omega method bases on an alternating current driven resistance, which is modulated with a frequency omega. Due to Joule heating, the temperature is then modulated with double the frequency, because actually Joule heating does not have a sign. And therefore, because the resistance has a defined temperature coefficient of resistance, if the temperature is modulated with the frequency omega, the resistance is also modulated with the frequency omega. And the voltage across the resistor due to Ohm's law is then, or contains then, of two terms. One term is modulated with one omega, but there is also a second term which is modulated with three times the frequency omega. And this three omega term contains information about the thermal properties of the surrounding. And here it has to be mentioned that it is also sensitive to volume or mass flow. Nevertheless, this term, this three omega term, is the signal of interest and is measured in this investigation. A third note is that it has to be mentioned that the resistor is the heater and the sensor. So to the sensor itself, we used a platinum thin film element, which is applied on a zirconia substrate. And it's structured by standard thin film lithography. Afterwards, the sensitive element or the sensitive thin film is covered by a protective glass layer. Yes. And the platinum is chosen because it has a relatively high temperature coefficient of resistance. In this case, it's around 3,900 parts per million per Kelvin. And it shows superb long-term stability. The pattern structure contains two structures. One structure is the heater or the three omega resistor, which is used to do the three omega method. It has a value of 45 ohms at 0 degrees. But there is also a second structure with a value of 1,200 ohms at 0 degrees. And the idea of this second structure is to measure the ambient temperature of the fluid. Because it might be crucial to know the temperature because most probably temperature compensation is needed if a certain range of temperature wants to be covered. And finally, and this sensor is then actually brought in direct contact with the fluid. So to the setup, as you may know, one challenge to measure the voltage at the frequency three omega is that the signal of interest, or the three omega signal, is around three orders of magnitude smaller than the driving signal. But because the signal of interest is separated in the frequency domain, a locking amplification technique can be used to measure the signal of interest. A third advantage is that such a technique is phase sensitive regarding the driving signal and the measurement signal. And actually, we assume that there is a phase shift between the driving signal and the measurement signal because the temperature and the heat flux has a certain lag to each other, which results in a phase shift. We developed a digital locking amplifier where the key part is a data acquisition card from National Instruments. This data acquisition card generates the signal, but also measure the voltage across the resistor. Therefore, the timing is defined, and no physical reference signal is needed, which can be seen as an advantage of a digital Ogging amplifier. The entire setup is controlled by a computer via a LabVIEW program. In this investigation, the driving frequency is varied between 0.1 Hz and 10 Hz, and the current amplitude is 30 milliamps. Now we want to look at the results or how the signal behaves for different urea concentration in water. So we varied the urea concentration between 0 and 50%. So 0% is pure water and 50% is close to the limit where urea is still dissolvable in water. So on the right side, you see the result. So the 3 omega signal as function of the drive frequency. Two main observations can be made. First, the amplitude decreases as a function of the drive frequency. The reason lies in the penetration depth of the excitation. The larger the frequency, the lower the penetration of the thermal wave, and the smaller the thermal response of the system. Second, a strong fluid dependency is visible between the different urea water concentration, especially for low frequencies, for low driving frequency. We see that the highest urea concentration has the highest signal and water has the smallest signal, but the urea concentration is obviously the lowest. Therefore, we already see that the 3 omega method can be used to distinguish between different urea concentration. On the other side, we also can have a look on the phase. So on the right side, you see the phase, so the lag between temperature and heat flux as a function of the driving frequency. So in principle, we see again two observations, two observations can be made. First, the phase does not behave or be monotonically as a function of the drive frequency. One sees actually a local minimum at around 0.2 Hertz. Second, the phase also shows a fluid dependency. However, the fluid dependency is not well visible at 0.1 Hertz, and a clear trend is visible from 0.2 to around 5 Hertz. Why do I talk about the phase? Because as you see, the amplitude shows a much clearer trend than the phase. But the phase is in first order not dependent on the current amplitude and the resistance value. And therefore, the phase might be interesting with regard to application and the serial production, because calibration processes can be simpler and the calibration effort can be smaller. Now we want to have a closer look on the fluid dependency of the 3 omega method. On the right side, you can see the amplitude as a function of the urea concentration for the frequency of 0.1 Hertz. a clear monotonically increasing function is visible. However, it's not linear. It's more like, yes, we have a small change in the slope. And the reason for that is actually that mainly that thermal conductivity for mixtures does not behave linearly as function of the concentration. Nevertheless, by repeating the measurement and taking the standard deviation, the resolution can be estimated. And the estimated resolution is around 1% for the entire concentration range. And with that, I want to close my talk. So what have we seen? The diesel exhaust fluid quality can be measured with a thermal sensor using the 3-omega method. And the resolution of the urea concentration is smaller than 1%. Next steps could be to develop a tailor-made electronic to enhance the resolution and to combine the 3-omega method with flow measurement, such that we can use the same element to measure flow and the urea concentration in a flowing fluid. And with that, I'd like to thank you for your attention. And if you have any question, please do not hesitate to ask me. Moreover, I will be happy to welcome you at our virtual booth of IST and Trudyne. And there we have a really fruitful collaboration between IST and Trudyne, such that we can enhance our sensors even more. So thank you.